Hello and welcome, myself Rehan Ali, and today in this video I'm gonna show you how can we configure our VS Code for compiling and running our C and C++ programs. Alright, so let's get started. Okay, I'm assuming that you already have installed the Visual Studio Code or VS Code in your computer. If it's not the case, you can simply download it from VS Code's official website. You can also find the link in the description of this video for the same. Installation process is very simple. Now, after downloading and installing VS Code, you may find this VS Code shortcut on your desktop from where you can open it and write your code there. Now, I already have created one folder on my desktop named text, and inside this folder, right click and choose option open with code. It simply means that we are opening our test folder with VS Code. This is completely up to you. You can save your files anywhere on your PC and open it from there also. Always. So first, I'll create the file named test.c. That means we are creating source file of C language. And I also write some C code here. Just for the side note, if you are opening this VS Code IDE first time and you also have the good internet connection, it may possible that VS Code will automatically show you one pop-up at your bottom right screen here for installing the C and C++ extension. You can click on that pop-up and install your C and C++ extension from there, but you can also download it from here, the option extensions from the view, or you can simply click on this icon where you will find any extension of your choice if it is available. Now simply type C here. You may find your C and C++ extension listed here. Download and install it. It will take some time to install all the tools related to C and C++. Now for running our C programs or maybe any programs, we also need to install another extensions that will allow us to run our code in simple way. In the search box, type code runner and install this extension as well. Now close this file and go to your explorer. Right click in the editor window and choose option run code. Here I am getting some error that is directly related to our C and C++ compiler, which is nothing but the GCC compiler. It simply means that GCC compiler is not installed on my machine. You may also get the same error, but don't worry, we'll solve this together. For installing GCC compiler, simply click on the link from the description labeled as MinGW. After opening it, you will get interface something like this. Here, download this file of 45 megabytes. As I already downloaded it, I'll use that file instead. After downloading that file, you will find this installation file. Just click on it and run the installer. Here, choose the location. I'll install it in my C drive's root folder. Simply type C colon slash, or you can also choose file location from here. Choose your C drive and click on extract button. It will extract all the required files from this package. Again, from making this video shorter, I'll show you the next steps. Now after extracting, you will find this MinGW folder in your C drive's root folder, as you can see here. Click on it and then click on bin folder. What actually we are gonna do here is that we'll set our environment variable so that system will easily find this compiler from anywhere in the system. In this case, from our VS Code terminal. Alright, so just copy this part and click on this PC here. Now here in this blank space, right click and select properties options. Now click on the advanced system settings, then select environment variables. Inside this, click on path and then edit option. Now click on new and paste your copied path here. Press OK for all the windows and close these both windows. Now again open VS Code and run the code. If you are getting any errors, close the VS Code and open it again to reflect our changes. Now when you right click and run your code, you'll see this output printed in the terminal. Congratulations! We successfully configured our VS Code for one C and C++ programs. But there is something that is missing here that we also need to set. By default, Code Runner will not allow us to take input from the user. Consider this example where I am asking user to enter any number and using the scanner function in C. If you now run this code, there is no any response. It seems like the screen has frozen. So now, for getting our input from the user, we need to enable Run in Terminal options in the Code Runner extension. For that purpose, go to Extensions and search for Code Runner that we installed earlier. Click on this icon button and then Extension Settings option. Scroll down it a bit and find Run in Terminal option there. Here it is. Just enable it, that's it. Now we can also take some inputs from the user. Close this file and let's close the VS Code itself so that whatever changes we made will reflect it properly. Now again, open VS Code and run your code here. That's it. Now we have successfully configured our VS Code to write, compile and run any C or C++ program. Alright, so if you like this video, please hit the like button. If you are new on the channel, don't forget to subscribe the channel and also click on the bell icon so that you won't be missed out any videos that I am planning to upload in coming future. That's being said, I hope to see you in the next video.